Good day, fellow investors. Facebook was one of your requested stocks to analyze. I did that already in August, so you can check the video here. And today I'm just going to give you an update, as Facebook is going to be one of the stocks that we are going to cover on this channel. I am long Facebook, for full disclosure, 3% of the portfolio, and I want to explain, okay, what's the news that happened, how that fits, if my earnings model has to be changed, and what do I see for Facebook in the future based on the latest news, which will surprise you because it won't be about the data breaches or things like that. So let's start discussing Facebook, which is a covered stock both on my stock market platform and from now on also on this YouTube channel. Let's go. In the last few months, some things happened that I think really went under the radar of Wall Street, because all the analysts are of course focusing on the news, on the data breaches, the issues Facebook has with regulation. But on the other hand, Facebook is continuing to develop their businesses, their monetization processes, despite what's going on, and they still have the daily, monthly active users. Instagram stories has beaten Snapchat, has destroying Snapchat. So all those things continue to evolve. And all the rest, I would put it as noise. There will be ups and downs, but the long term, the barriers to exit Facebook, if you are a normal person, all your connections are there, pictures, groups, the community is so strong, so that the Facebook's moat is becoming bigger and bigger. Let's see about the news. This is very important. The three pieces of information I want to discuss today is Instagram shopping, perhaps a shopping app, Instagram shopping app. So that leads into e-commerce, artificial intelligence, Oculus for $399, and the analyst's focus. So let's put things into perspective. For now, the leader in everything e-commerce related is Amazon, but Facebook has 2.3 billion monthly active users on their platform. So when this gets more traction, when you see something, artificial intelligence, you can click on this and Facebook gets a cut from the seller, then it might revolutionize the way we shop. There is rumors that Instagram is building a standalone shopping app, Instagram shopping. It will go to Facebook, it will grow. Facebook has already 25 million business accounts that are already on Facebook. So the base is there, the users are there, everything is already there. The key is now Facebook has to, of course, they are always slowly in testing, sending out, testing here, first going to the US, and that takes a lot of time, but they are doing it. So it is, I see limited downside on what's going on. The ad business for now will lead Facebook's revenues and profits, but with something like that, with going into e-commerce, that might be a bigger part of Facebook in the future that I don't see analysts talking about. Nobody talks about that, but it's here, it's starting to get traction. And it is something that I think adds value to Facebook, because the downside is limited. If it doesn't happen, Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, Messenger remain the same product, but if it happens, the upside is huge. However, it's already happening. It's going to be an Instagram Christmas. The marketplace is also introducing AI features. So from now on, you will be able to click on something. I think that's the test on the marketplace. They will spread it around on all the platforms, see what is similar, what are the prices, who is selling, when the shopping app is developed. And then you have something really, really big coming from Facebook, and Facebook earning a commission on every sale, and then letting Amazon or whomever else doing the logistics part. Perhaps they will even collaborate with Amazon one day. Well, you never know, it might be a good idea. Another thing that I have seen, okay, I never liked the Oculus acquisition, but they are really developing it, working hard. So new system, Oculus Quest, is coming in spring 2019. When that develops, when video develops, when everything develops, again, long term I'm talking here, this might really, really be something. Even if personally I don't like Oculus, but I, as I said, just be exposed to the upside. So we have shopping, e-commerce, artificial intelligence, Oculus, virtual reality, audio, video, everything that will be the future, Facebook is doing it. On top of it, Facebook has the customer base. Facebook has the consumer. Facebook knows a lot about the consumers. Nobody has that kind of data on consumers. And that's why Facebook has a big moat for me. That's why Facebook is in my portfolio for the long term, as I said, with 3% of the portfolio. So these are the news that I'm seeing. These are the news that I'm putting in my model. However, analysts don't put that kind of news. They put different stories. Just one quote from an analyst report. Facebook's guidance of margins trending to the mid-30s during the next couple of years as the company will be investing further in innovation, content creation, and data protection. So investing for the future is what is disappointing. And that's of course why the stock is down, because analysts always focus on the next few quarters, because such is the mentality of the market. Also, the majority of investors focus on the next few quarters, and that's why that's an opportunity for me. Let me show you my model. Nothing changes here. Growth rate 25% from ads as the price of the ads go higher, 15% in the next 5 years from all the new developments. That might be volatile, but when e-commerce comes, that might even go higher. So if I change those 15 to 25% for the subsequent 5 years, if it happens sooner, then we are at 282. So those are the things that I like to adjust my models. And with time, I will do it also on this platform, on this YouTube channel, and also, of course, on my stock market platform. So that's it, just an update. Facebook is growing, doing its business, developing the technology, increasing the community, increasing its moat. What will happen? I think that we are now at a place where there is downside. Yes, I hope Facebook would fall, I don't know, to 120 so that it becomes 2% of my portfolio so that I can increase it to 4%. If it falls to 80, highly unlikely, but then I would increase it to 5-6%. And that's my exposure to great businesses in the developed or even global markets in the portfolio that I'm building. That will be a global diversified portfolio around the world. We just finished looking at China. There will be two more videos about Chinese real estate on Saturday. Tomorrow the news. So keep watching, keep commenting, keep liking, keep subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.